Hi, I'm Isabel.
And this is Emma.
And this is Tomcat TV.
Hey, Coach Smith, my name is Jakaan Jones, and your name?
Coach Chris Smith.
What's going through your head Friday night before the game?
Just all the preparation, all the hard work a lot of the guys did this summer, what it takes to get to that point, especially during, you know, all the stuff that's going on right now in society, that, you know, these guys brought it every day, lifting weights in the off season, running sprints, doing the best they could, and that those guys, I knew they were well prepared before they came out on the field, and I think our guys were relaxed and ready to play football, and they've been waiting a long time to get to play in front of the Haywood County Tomcats and students and fans and the whole community, and I think they represented the community with class, and I think it's exciting style of football they play Friday.
What do you expect for this season?
One of the big things we expect every year is our team to get better every single week. You know, we told the guys, you know, we're back to 0-0. This week's the only week that matters, and that, you know, last year we did a great job of getting better every week, even though we missed some games here or there. But that's one of the things that's going to separate the teams at the end versus the teams right now, is how much better they get on a week-to-week basis. So are we satisfied? Are we going to stay hungry and try to improve to get even better than where we currently are? So that's, you know, you want to keep the end goal in mind too a lot of the times. You know, a lot of times people can see what's only right in front of them. They don't see what's back here. So we're prepping to try to be the best version of ourselves at Haywood.
Coach Smith, have a nice day.
All right. Go Tomcats. All gas, no brakes.
Hi. My name is Jakaan, and we with
Jalen Lewis.
What was going through your head first game?
Going through my head first game, we was going to win automatically.
How many years you been starting?
Three. It's my third year. It starts in my sophomore year.
How many D1 commits you got?
I got 34 offers total.
Hey, this is Emma Milton, and I'm with
Andrew Barron.
And on this segment of Tomcat TV, we're doing odd talents. Andrew, do you have any odd talents?
Yeah.
Will you show us?
Sure.
What's your name?
Cam Miller.
Do you have any talents?
I can do a backflip.
Can you show us?
Yeah, I got you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yo! Yo! Hey, what's your name?
Kyrie.
Do you have any odd talents?
No, backflip.
Okay, can you do that for us?
Yeah.
Yo! What's your name?
My name's Sebastian Woods.
Do you have any odd talents?
Yeah, I can do something weird with my thumb.
Can you show us?
Sure.
Whoa.
That's another angle. Put it like this. Yo! Hi.
Today we're here with the contestants.
Sean.
Miss Tyus.
Jake. Delta.
And they'll be doing the free will up challenge. 3, 2, 1.
Bro, my
food.
You
cheated,
son.
I'm stupid.
I don't know who's winning right now. Ah, Sean.
Maya fell.
Miss Ty's the winner. Miss Ty's the winner.
Today I'm here with Ken.
Miss
Rose.
Miss Dolls.
And DE4 right here is going to do the Pool Roller Challenge. When I count to three, y'all will begin. 1, 2, 3.
Hello, this is Ivory Ann Parks with
Callie Coates.
Miss Coates, what class do you teach this year?
I teach agri-science, and I also teach agriculture leadership and communication.
How many years did you work towards your job now?
So this is my fifth year at Haywood High School.
Why did you want to become a teacher?
Well, I really love agriculture, and I enjoy working with teenagers, and so this seemed to be a natural fit.
Do you consider your job easy, and why?
I don't consider it easy, but it is definitely enjoyable.
Okay, Ms. Coates, this is a weird question, but how much wood could a woodchuck chuck if the diameter of a river equaled the circumference of the polar ice caps in a jungle of orange beds?
I'm not really sure, but that number seems to be going down since the polar ice caps are melting.
Sports. You got a favorite teacher, son?
Mr.
McCann. Shout out Mid-Tie in the background. Love you, Mid-Tie.
Do you think the football gonna win state?
They could. It's possible.
Who we with? What? Who we with?
Slimy dude.
Man, we ask all this. Tell a name.
Jelly.
Who the best basketball player on your team?
Me.
What's one thing you like about the school?
One thing, the students.
Who the best football player?
Who the best football player? I'm gonna say Pearson.
It might be your family or something. He might be related to you.
Yeah, that's my cousin.
What's the top five baddest girls in your opinion at school? What sport get the most attention in school? JB real. We already know football, but
all right, bro, let me say it. Football.
Yeah, thank you.
Something I like about high school, the food is great.
You capping. What's the best sport in Haywood?
Basketball.
Football. What get the most attention in school? Football.
Basketball.
Football.
But hey, we all got different things.
Dude, hold on.
What about outside of sports, though?
Basketball has a state championship, right?
Yeah. Speak your truth, Mike.
Football don't have a state championship, right?
Speak your truth.
So who needs to have more attention, basketball or football?
You right. But who get the more money, though? Basketball or football?
Basketball.
Who get the more attention?
Right. Basketball.
Still on the Jitrit. Yeah. All right, here go to class. What's your favorite subject?
Math.
He garbage at that. What sport? What's the best sport of Haywood?
Basketball.
Of course, you say that.
Yeah, I like coming to the school because I like seeing a lot of bad joints.
What's something you like about this school?
The girls.
What you tired of seeing at school?
I'm tired of people walking slow to class.
I'm tired of seeing folks like Robert McAtee on a basketball team. But hey, what's the best basketball player in Haywood?
On the team in Haywood, on the high school team.
Yeah,
probably Tyler.
Oh my God. Who the best football player in Haywood?
J. Lou.
And why? What you tired of seeing at school?
Honestly, nothing. I'm enjoying my time here. I saw a piece of a girl's weave on the ground in the lunchroom the other day. I'm not even kidding. And I was like, wow, this is great.
What I hate about school, Monday through Friday. Should be Monday through Thursday.
This is Tomcat TV. My name is Andrew Barron. What's your name?
Cynthia Turner.
Dapple Newprin.
So, how long have y'all been working here at Haywood High?
I actually started in 1990, so that gives me about 31 years.
Dang.
I've been here 28 years.
Dang. Do y'all enjoy?
I really do. My favorite part about it is feeding the kids. I love to see their faces when they come through the line and greet them every morning. So.
That's good.
My favorite part is cooking good old spaghetti for them. They love that spaghetti.
That spaghetti's good, though.
Yes.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
This is Gabrielle Williams with
Mr. Nash.
And this is Guess the Lyrics.
I'm Shaquilla Wood and I'm here with
Miss Byram.
And today we're doing Finish the Lyric.
I do not know.
This is Gabrielle Williams with
Mr. Lee.
And we're finishing lyrics.
I'm Shaquille Weddle, and I'm here with
Miss Avent.
And today we playing Finish the Lyric.
So they got them apple bottom jeans and the boots with the fur.
I'm Macy Fair with Tomcat TV, and I'm here with
Miss Ty.
Okay, Miss Ty. Miss Ty, how do you feel about these children that you have to open the CTE door for because they don't have their ID?
They just gonna stand out there until they go in their backpack and purse and get their ID and then open up the door, so I'm not getting up anymore.
You hear that? She done made it known and opening no more doors.
In the CTE building, do not come over there without your ID. I'm not getting up again.
Miss Tyus is not getting up again. She is not opening the door for y'all. Thank you.
My name is Raven, and we're doing Tomcat TV today. We're doing football cheer interviews, and we're here with
Miss Simpson.
Okay, Miss Simpson, is being a cheer coach something you're passionate about and why?
Yes, it is. I've been cheering since I was in third grade. I've done sideline, competitive. I've coached all-star. I've coached high school. I've coached collegiate. So seeing the progress, the light bulbs, the success, and seeing the potential outside of school, money, scholarships, and all that other stuff, it warms my heart. So yes, it has a special place in my
okay.
heart.
We have two more questions, but they kind of fall in with each other. What advice would you give students that have not yet taken a dual enrollment course?
Once you get to your junior, senior year, it's really important to start preparing for after high school, whether it be going to college, whether it be going to a trade school like TCAT. It's very important that you prepare for that. So making sure that your 9th and 10th grade years, getting your GPAs to that eligible spot is first most important. But being able to exit high school and have a good amount of your college already completed not only puts you ahead of the game, it makes it more likely for you to complete your college education, and it makes it significantly cheaper for you to complete your education.
Okay. What advice would you give students that are just starting out with dual enrollment courses?
It's not high school, so it is going to be a little bit different, but you have to make sure that you apply yourself 100%. It's better to take them now because it's free college courses. It's better to take them now and get them out of the way, but at the same time, apply yourself 100% to make sure that you are setting yourself up for success once you graduate from high school.
Okay. I asked those two questions because Ms. Simpson is also our dual enrollment coordinator for the school. So if you have any questions about dual enrollment or anything of that nature, feel free to come to Ms. Simpson. Her office is the first office on the right in the guidance office. Thank you.
I'm Macy Farrell here with our first cheerleader,
Jordan Connor.
How many years have you been involved in cheer?
This is my first year cheering for the high school.
Is being a cheerleader for Haywood High School, is this what you expected?
Yeah, basically.
In a respectful manner, if you could change anything about being a cheerleader here, what would you change?
Nothing much. I enjoy it a lot.
Okay, and do you plan on continuing cheer throughout the rest of your high school years?
Definitely.
We're here with our second first-year cheerleader.
My name is Emma Watson.
How many years have you been cheerleading?
This is my first year.
Okay, so our first question is, how do you feel about being a cheerleader here at Haywood High School for your first year?
I really like it, honestly. It's a lot of fun, and it gets me back into something that I'm very passionate about, which is gymnastics or tumbling. I honestly do really like it, a lot more than I thought I would.
Is it what you expected?
I honestly didn't know what to expect. I've never cheered before, really. It's better than I expected in a way, but I just really like it. I like it. I mean, being honest.
Okay, in a respectful manner, if you could change something about the cheerleading team or anything of that nature, what would you change?
I would honestly change everybody's attitude towards it, just for the simple fact of there being people who downgrade themselves and say that they can't do it, do a certain thing. I even have done that before, and I've had to overcome those fears, and I just wish everybody would be a little bit more positive about it sometimes. But that's probably the one thing I would change.
Okay. Do you plan on continuing with cheer next year?
I do. I honestly don't see why I would just do it for this one year and not finish it out. It's something that I enjoy, so I do plan on finishing out next year too.
Is there anything else you would like to say?
I guess that's it.
Thank you.
Hey, I'm Ashton Doyle, and I'm here with our third cheerleader,
Asia Silas.
How many years have you been cheering, Asia?
3.
All right. Since you started cheer, what cheer have you learned that is your favorite?
I honestly have to say it was a defense cheer.
What made cheerleading something you're passionate about?
I'm a backspot for stunts, so it's fun to, like, learn new stunts. And then when your group finally hits it, it's, like, something that's in you that makes you – it's like – when football players make a touchdown, it's just really fun.
All right, in a respectful manner, what do you wish were different?
I wish that our girls had more confidence in themselves. They seem to, like Emma said, they seem to downgrade themselves and say that they can't do it, and they have a lot of potential in them. So I just wish they had more confidence in themselves. I wish they weren't so attitude-ish. And bratty, I guess. I don't know. But I love my girls. I love my girls. They're my little sisters. I love them. So, yeah.
Well, do you plan on continuing cheer next year?
Oh, for sure. Next year is my senior year.
I'm here with our fourth cheerleader,
Christian Reed.
Okay, Christian, how many years have you been cheering?
I've been cheering 2 years.
Okay, what made you decide to cheer again this year?
I just like how when you have friends and then you just start cheering and you have fun, and then, like, you make new friends, you get to go places, you have new experiences, and it opens doors to different places and such.
Okay. The cheering this year, do you think it's more difficult or easier than cheering last year was?
I think it's more difficult because we are being pushed to our most different limits. So we're going past our own limits, past our comfort zones, so that we can be better within the future, and we can possibly win championships for HHS's new competition cheer team.
Okay. In a respectful manner, what do you wish was different about the cheer team if you could change anything?
I would say within a way of how the spectrum is put upon us, of how we are not a sport within the community, because the community doesn't know that we're really a sport, even though the school somewhat knows we are a sport, which we are, because you can be hurt. Like, cheering within competition is literally $1,000 to even get into for some things and such.
Okay, and do you plan on continuing cheer next year and throughout the rest of your high school year?
Absolutely, it's the best. Thank you.
Emma and Asia are about to do a cheer called Back It Up Defense for us. You guys cheer them on. We know you can't see them, but give your cheerleader support.
Back it up, defense. Back, back, back it up, defense. Back, back, back it up, defense. Back, back, back it up, defense.
Hey, this is Emma, and this is
Mr. McCain,
and we're here with Dad Jokes.
All right, what goes all the way around the baseball field but never moves?
I don't know.
The fence.
was real funny.
You have another one?
I do. Ran out of toilet paper and started using lettuce leaves. Today was just the tip of the iceberg. Tomorrow remains to be seen.
I don't get it.
Iceberg lettuce.
Oh, yeah. I'm a great vegetarian.
What do you get when you drop a piano on an army officer?
I know this one. Oh, sorry. Never mind.
A flat major.
That was pretty good, Mr. McCain. That was great.
What do you call a group of baby soldiers?
Something duty.
No. An infantry.
My dad told me these yesterday.
I was excited to hear Apple might start selling its own cars until I learned they wouldn't support Windows.
Is that all?
I got a few more.
Oh, okay.
Want to hear a joke about paper?
Mm-hmm.
Never mind, it's terrible.
These are so...
another one?
What kind of egg did the evil chicken lay?
A deviled egg,
yes. Yeah. This is my favorite one. Mm-hmm. How do you follow Will Smith in the snow?
Fresh Prince.
Yeah!
That's it.
There
we go, okay.
This is Gabrielle Williams with
Ehoy,
Shaquille Waddle.
And this is Guess That Food.
What they finna give us, TK?
I'll try.
You say try? Yes. I bet you I can tell you.
What the heck?
Oreo hash. I can't see. Oh, yeah, Oreo. They're my favorite candy.
My candy, bro. I
finally hate it.
What is this?
Yeah, that's Oreo. That's that white chocolate.
Yup,
mm-hmm.
Little Oreos
in
white Hershey.
Mm, no, I remember
no.
I gave my dog to it.
Nope. Mm-mm. I used to stay in these hoes.
I don't know what this is.
This is good stuff.
Mm-hmm. Ooh. Brent gonna eat, and he know he eating.
It smells like some bubble gum.
Can we eat it?
Yeah.
Can we eat?
Eat.
Let me tell you this.
Oh.
Oh,
yeah,
they gave
us. Hey, that's that little baby food, ain't it?
Yep, baby food. Baby food.
Baby puffs.
Yeah, that's baby food.
No, they baby stars. It's like some little stars. This is a star. Yeah,
you must see it.
No, fool, I can feel it, bro.
That was serious.
I got a little cousin to eat this shit.
Mm-hmm, baby food.
Yeah. Yeah, can somebody get this on my paper towel, though? Yeah, thanks. Can we eat it?
Yeah, see.
A Kit Kat. I didn't Kit Kat.
Kit Kat. Kit Kat bar. My kitty.
I can't
even
sound like one.
We can eat.
Ow! Oh! Oh!
You
can
feel it.
Yes,
I'm
eating.
Ooh, I'm not eating it, bro.
Hey, this, I know what this is. This is sardine. I can smell it, bro.
Yeah, this sardine. Dude, these folks got a fish on the table, bro. No, fool, no. I'm not eating that. No.
How I hear you. Right here. No, bro. Foul on my mama.
This what's wrong with you, bro?
It's a sardine for real.
Hey, you eat no sardines?
Hey,
no,
bro. Man, on my life, though, huh? You don't want to.
Man, you can't, man.
Who said they got a fish on me?
Pass.
No, fat on me. No, fat on me.
I don't want no parts of
this. Sardine, fine.
No.
You better eat. It's already cooked. It's mine right here.
Is the eyeballs in it?
Nah, it's cooked.
You said the eyeballs cooked,
bro. It just cooked. Is this mine? What the heck? Taste what it is fat on my life.
Dude, don't eat the good.
What you mean?
I can't
eat it.
It is eatable.
Damn,
I can eat this, y'all.
You want mine, bro? No, fool, that's mad, man. I don't care.
Brayden, don't look at it. Just put it in your mouth.
I can't look at it.
Hold on, pause. Put it in your mouth. Pause. It's fat, fool. God, I just ate my whole thing.
My mouth's still on fire,
though. My mouth's still hot.
Brayden, this stuff looks so nasty, dude.
Damn,
He know it's fine.
All right, can we get our next item back? Ooh, hot though. Hey,
It's fine, little bit of
it's all right. Look at that little tuna. Little
you were going down over there on that.
I ain't eating mine. Hey, boy, what's taking y'all so long?
I can't eat mine.
Hi, my name is Marcella, and today we're doing random questions.
My name's Talisha.
And I'm Miss Byram.
And today the question for the day is, if you was born 5 years ago, how old would you be?
41.
No.
Oh, God.
It's 5 years.
I would be 5. I mean, 20. I mean, 4.
Hi, my name is Marcella, and today we're doing random questions.
My name's Talisha.
My name, Doody.
And the question is, if you was born 5 years ago, how old would you be?
Until I answer. 10.
It's 5.
For real?
Mm-hmm. Oh. Hi, my name is Marcella, and today we're doing random questions.
My name is Talisha.
My name is Miss Avent.
And today, the question for the day is, if you was born 5 years ago, how old would you be?
5 years ago from today? Mm-hmm. Okay, I would be 5.
Good job.
Oh, okay, yay!
I got it wrong.
Hi, my name is Marcella, and today we're doing random questions.
My name is Talisha.
And my name is Macklin Williamson.
And the question for today is, if you were born 5 years ago, how old would you be?
And I would be 21.
No. You would be 5.
That would mean I'm 10 now. If I were born 5 years ago, that would mean I'd have to be 10 now to be 5 years ago. But I'm not 10. I'm 26. So 26 minus 5 is 21, dang it. This is making no sense to me. I was born 5 years ago. Oh!
Hi, my name is Marcella Sanchez, and we're doing random questions today.
My name is Holly Chagant.
My name is Anthony Jones.
And the question for today is, if you was born 5 years ago, how old would you be?
If I was born 5 years ago, mm-hmm. How old would I be? Probably 5.
Good job!
I mean, I got a little sense.
Hi, my name is Marcella, and today we're doing random questions.
My name is Talisha.
My name is Trevika.
And the question of the day is, if you was born 5 years ago, how old would you be?
11?
No.
I'll be 11.
No,
you
would be
16.
Five.
Wait.
Hi, my name is Marcella, and today we're doing random questions.
And my name is Talisha.
My name's Ashley.
And the question of the day is, if you was born 5 years ago, how old would you be?
I'd be like 9.
You would be 5.
Girl, I'm 14.
5 years ago.
Get it. Just say your name.
Elma.
What's your name?
K-9.
Do you have any odd talents?
Yeah, I can hit a backflip off the wall.
Can you show us?
Yeah.
Bloopers. Thank you.
Welcome back to Tomcat TV, where Kristen's on the floor and everyone's watching.
Okay. Okay. Are you
ready?
Do a flip!
Oh my Emma. God!
Emma. Hey, this is Emma, and this is
Andrew.
I made a face.
Hey.
Can you not? I was go. In the middle of doing a good one.
Okay.
You can't hear like the water?
Hey, this is Emma, and I'm with...
Okay, sorry. One more time.
Since you started cheer, what is your favorite...
No, you forgot a question. No, that's the first question. No, how...
How many years have you been cheering? It's okay,
that's not on the first one.
It is. It's right up here.
Well, it's up at the top.
Okay, so
is
what?
Is this still rolling?
What am I supposed to say? What am I supposed to say? What am I supposed to say?
For sports schedules or any other information, go to HaywoodSchools.com or Haywood High School Facebook page. Thanks for watching.